Kids are heading back to school and crossing streets to get there, but how will they know when it's safe to cross in this new world of driverless cars? Find out on NSF Science now. Crossing a road looks easy, right? A hand wave, flashing headlights, or a car coming to a complete stop are cues we trust to know it's safe to cross. But with driverless vehicles, these signals might change or disappear. With an estimated 3.5 million self-driving vehicles expected on U.S. roads by next year, how will children and other pedestrians know that the autonomous vehicle intends to stop and let them cross? NSF-supported researchers at the University of Iowa are investigating how to make road crossing safe for everyone, especially children, in a world with self-driving cars.
I think that our research is showing that how these vehicles are signaling to pedestrians and other vulnerable road users is really critical, and that the timing of that signal in particular is very important for keeping children and adults safe.
The team used virtual reality to study how 100 preteens determined whether and when it was safe to cross a busy residential street with driverless cars.
So we're able to use a large screen immersive virtual environment to conduct our studies. It's one of only a handful that we're aware of in the world. And it provides a unique experimental design. We're able to control all of the elements in the environment from the traffic, and we can eliminate all other distractions in the environment, allowing us to really examine closely the behaviors that we're interested in.
The researchers observed and recorded when the children decided to cross the street. Here's how it works.
So the way that we did the study is in a virtual environment, and the kids stood at the edge of the virtual roadway, and they watched a pair of cars that came from the left-hand side. The first car always kept going, but the second car sometimes stopped for them. And so that second car was the driverless vehicle. And that driverless vehicle decelerated either gradually or abruptly.
The driverless car was outfitted with a unique dome light to signal the car's intent.
And most importantly, it had a dome light on the top that turned green to indicate that it intended to yield to the child. And if it stayed red, it meant that it was not going to yield to the child. So the child's job was to watch, especially that second car, and decide if and when it was okay to cross the road in front of that vehicle.
Afterward, the team interviewed the children to gauge their understanding of the dome light system test.
Well, in our interviews with children afterward, we did find that they understood the dome light and what it meant, which was encouraging.
How did you know when it was safe to cross?
Well, I kind of looked at the light, and then if it was green, then I immediately started crossing. And if it stayed red for too long, then I said not to cross.
When the light came on early, children exhibited riskier crossing behavior when the car's green light came on just as the car began to slow down, compared to when it came on after the car had come to a complete stop. When the light appeared later, they waited for the car to stop before crossing. They understood the green light as a crossing signal and trusted that it was safe to cross.
So the vehicle would stop, and then the light would turn on, and children would wait for that light as their signal that it's okay to cross. And we believe that this is a much safer way for driverless cars to communicate their intent to yield to a pedestrian, as it doesn't result in the pedestrian entering the roadway prior to the vehicle coming to a complete stop. If there's any sort of miscommunication or unexpected event on the roadway that may have to change that driverless car's behavior, the pedestrian is not in the road and at risk.
Signaling is critical for keeping children safe.
I think some of the broader impacts of this research are particularly relevant for policymakers when it comes to designing systems for these driverless vehicles. We need a consistent way for these vehicles to communicate with pedestrians about their intent, one that needs to be understood by our most vulnerable road users, children.